Airbus and landing along the Litus Importuosum, dangerous coast, are Santa Severa, Civitas Vetula and Corneto. The Mediterranean coastline between Santa Severa and Corneto, nearly 50 km north of Rome, isn't suitable seashore to dock ships. In fact, the whole coast of Latium are as some odds. In particular, the sea bottom isn't flat. It is often exposed to silting and erosion. Lagoons and marshes are the main feature of most areas along the coastal plain. Historical sources, medieval pilot book or travel chronicles describe this natural environment, confirming the label of Litus Importuosum, dangerous coast, used by Pliny the Younger to describe it in the 2nd century AD. For instance, the Corneto's harbor accessibility is highly representative. Its intense activity is well known throughout the Middle Age. The medieval town landings were located in the nearby river's mouth. They used to be affected by silting, especially in summer. David Abulafia proposed that they tried to bypass this hold by docking all the ships in the small bay of Santa Marina, facing Santa Marinella Tower, now the little village of Santa Marinella. But like the most part of bays in the surroundings, this one used to be quite small. Two 17th century pilot books, written by Giacomo Galletti e Bartolomeo Crescenzi, advise us that a miglia 2 vi è una torre, Santa Marinella, dove a bisogno si salverebbero due o tre galere. 2 miles away there is the Tower of Santa Marinella, where you can store two or three galley. And nel voltar del capo vi è Santa Marinella, ove a un poco di stanza d'un bisogno, after the Capo Linaro, you can find Santa Marinella, where there is a small place to land. Coastal erosion, due both to natural and human activities, affected the shaping of the shoreline, so possibly not to landings of this region. This phenomenon is particularly clear at Capo Linaro Bay, along the coastline, in front of the Roman colony of Castrum Novum. Here, ancient buildings being studied by Grégoire Poccardi, University of Lille, are visible along more than 200 meters long strip of coast. According to a research undergone by Fabrizio Antonioli, Kurt Lambeck e Marco Ansidei, during the last 2000 years, erosion and consequently the sea level rise used to reach the rate of 2, 8 and 7 centimeters per century, with a marked increase during the 18th century, about 20 centimeters, due to the increase of the ocean's temperature and Earth's atmosphere. Marshes are often considered within 19th century sources focused mainly, so not only, on malaria. Rutilius Namazianus already describes Mignones Mouth and Graviscas Harbour as area infested by exhalations. The author quotes a Catos text preserved through service account that suggests the name Graviscae would come from the unhealthy environment of the surroundings. In the 14th century, Giovanni Villani points out to many people who are nowadays worn out due to the unhealthy air, when he describes the process that made this area deserted in the 19th century. Concerning with, we must quote the AD 1842 Charles Didier passage, The only buildings of these sad areas are watchtowers built from place to place to defend the coast. Soldiers here deployed do not need to defend themselves from privateers or smugglers, but from the malaria. The few inhabitants obliged by necessity to live here, postilions, workers, are all struck by the plague. During the Middle Age, the presence of marshes led to a partial abandonment of the coastal route to Rome, concentrated on Via Aurelia. The road is seldom mentioned as the case, as in the case of the privilege to Pope Benedict VIII, in a tour report by James II the Just, and in some pilgrims' diaries who came to Rome for the Jubilee of 1400 and 1500. Despite this, some relevant herbs used to be active in this region and along the Litus Importosum during the Middle Age. Among them, that of the Etruscan town of Caere, the harbour of Pyrgi that corresponded to the medieval harbour of Santa Severa, the Roman harbour of Centum Cellae, now Città Vecchia, and the medieval harbour of Civitas Vetula and Corneto. The former enrice the functions of Centum Cellae. A major change in the trading development of the region was promoted by Trajan. In the 2nd century AD, the emperor promoted the naming of the harbour of Centum Cellae, aiming to enrich the landing network to supply Rome. The description of the works is recorded by Plinius the Younger in a famous letter to Cornelianus. In fact, he writes that iam per longissimum spatium litus importosum hoc receptaculo utetur. Apollodorus of Damascus is presumed to be the architect of this work. It consists of a dock and two piers of a different shape. The first one was a half-circle structure on the west side to prevent that the main streams could affect the ships. The second one, positioned in the eastern side, less affected by the stream, was more straight. Each of them had a lighthouse, while a two-towered fore wall was positioned before them. According to the comparari viewers, Centum Cellae, should like an architectural achievement. It was so impressive that still in the 19th century, a pilot book described it as the most beautiful and best made harbour of the world. Excavation in Castrum Novum, the Roman colony, whose more ancient landing used to be the north of Capolinaro Bay, show that a balneum was built right in this period on the landing site. The town was embellished with an odeion, whose chronology is ensured by the stamped bricks used to build it. The balneum and the odeion witness that Trajan's harbour did not lead to the abandonment of former landing. On the contrary, it favoured their increasing activity. The harbour network reshaped by Trajan along the Litus Importosum hardly survived during the early Middle Age due to the Saracen raids on the Tyrrhenian coast. They recovered during the High Middle Age. In fact, since the 12th century, northern Latium coast used to be within a large trading network, spanning from Sicily to Liguria and the eastern coast of Sardinia and Corsica. According to Luciano Palermo, the route trip of a 14th century galea to Naples, quote by Muratori, provide a clear description of the most popular route of the period. The ship was loaded with French tissues at Avignon and Marseille to leave direct to Monaco, Genoa, Pisa, Piombino and Civitavecchia. The harbors of Civitavecchia, former Centumcicale, and Santa Severa, the Etruscan harbor of Pirgi, that survived up in the Middle Age, still used the Roman docks, while the harbor of Corneto is a network of landings along the river mouth. The main good traded with the ship, oils, was mailing crop cultivated in the surrounding valleys and addressed to the markets of Rome and Genoa. There it used to be exchanged with tissues, pottery, leather, and seldom slaves. In Tarquinia Corneto, one can find some storage pit for crops cultivated in the valley of the region. It used to be a two-step storing process. During the first one, the crop was stored in pits near the field where it used to be cultivated. Then it was moved to the pits near the markets, waiting to be uploaded into the ships. Relevant expenses were made to buy or to rent pits, and those related to the personnel involved in controlling the staff and granting a good ventilation. The finds of Corneto excavation prove exchanges made with Tuscany and Liguria, witnessed by coins, and with Sardinia. From here, Corneto received a large quantity of pottery hispano-moresca, mainly during the 15th century. The ships sailing along this route used to carry out the cabotage, where we could find many arbors as well as a series of approaching areas. The pilot book of Angelo Custaguti is one of the main texts to locate the approaching areas. At the beginning of the 18th century, the author mentioned 16 bay where the ship could be approached, among the three harbors of Santa Severa, Civitavecchia and Corneto. Recent archaeological investigation prove that these places have been chosen according to the geographical setting of the Litus Importoso. In fact, they are located near the rivers, mounds, in specially in area protected by the wind. Most of the landing mentioned by Custaguti used to be active during the Middle Age, and they overlaid some Roman posiciones and stationes located in the Itinerarium Maritimum in the 4th century AD. To finish, the geographical setting of the strip of coast shows a series of physical hurdles: coastal erosion, seabed silting, risk of flooding, lagoons. However, it did not prevent the making of a multifunctional landscape characterized by silt work and cultivated fields whose product used to fill in the cargo holds. Since the time of Trajan, this area was mentioned as not really suitable for ship landing, but it was included in a large network of Mediterranean trades whose peak was reached during the 15th century after the discovery of Alan Yanis.
Thank you.
I cut.